Right, so here's the part where you sew the two pieces of fabric together to make your headband. So I'm sewing one side the whole length without stopping, and the other side is half and half, leaving a gap, and I'll show you that now in a second. So you're just sewing a straight seam at 5/8 of an inch. When you get to your angle, make sure you lift to change the direction that you're going. And if you want to, it's a good idea right at the tip of the point and the top of the headband on either side to sew and go back on it. That will make it harder for the wire to come through in case it's yanked in any way by the person wearing it. And then back to your straight stitch. I'm going to leave about an inch gap, if you can see that, because I started in the middle originally, because that's where I'm going to turn the headband fabric inside out and iron it down and then put the wire through. So just remember to go back on that, take it off, cut your stitches. So it should look like that. There's your gap in the middle, and then your straight stitch and your seam allowance at the side. So now we're going to turn it inside out. Right, so before we turn it inside out, you want to iron down your seams flat. Use steam in the iron because this will help the finish of the headband, so it's not lumpy and bumpy and it sits well. So you open up your seams, steam them down. Yeah. As you can see, they're totally flat now, and that will make a huge difference when the headband is turned inside out. So do that with the rest of the seam, and then we'll turn the headband inside out. Right, so all your seams are flat now and ready to turn inside out the headband. I'm going to leave the iron on because I'm going to want to iron the seams down once it's turned inside out. So as you can see, I'm looking for the gap here that we had from earlier, the 1-inch gap. And you're going to, well, it'd be very hard. You could do it with maybe like something with a point at the end of it, but you need to get one of these. It has a little hook on the end, and that pulls the corners inside out. You'll get one in your local fabric shop. So put it in and push it right to the end and hook it into the fabric. Mine's a bit blunt from doing so many of them. And then you start to turn it inside out. I'll leave the camera on while I do this, so in case you think you're doing it wrong, it does take a minute or so. And if the hook falls out, just pull the fabric back and start again. So there, that's one side pulled out. I'm going back into the gap, going down to the other end and sticking my hook in the point. I just wanted to mention as well, the reason I'm using white thread is because it's winter here and it's very dark. So to be able to show you what I'm actually doing, at least the white thread pokes out. If I used red, it would probably be very hard for you to see the tutorial. So if you're using red fabric or whatever fabric you're using, get the colour thread that you need for it. Obviously looks a lot better. See, mine's after falling out there because I was talking. Hold on a sec. Me under pressure there. Put my hook back through and start turning inside out again. Just rushing too much there. I was trying to make it as short a tutorial for you as possible. But once you start doing it, you'll get the hang of it and it'll come easy enough to you after a few times practicing it. You'll be able to make your own headbands. If you try it and you actually can't do it, I make headbands and sell them on eBay and Etsy. If you look up Pin Me Up Ireland, I have a variety of headbands of that. In all different prints and made out of Alexander Henry fabric. So check it out if you get a chance. So I'm sticking my point back in even though it's turned inside out because I want to even out all the seams, especially the points. And do that with the other side as well, and then we'll iron it down. Right, so when it's turned inside out, you want to iron down your seams. So that they're nice and neat. Then it will look like that. You can separate it out a bit so it's not too flat. Then the next thing you do is get your wire and you want to measure it the same length as the headband, but leave enough for a little hook on either side because you don't want that straight part because that's just going to cut through the fabric. So first of all, get the first end, bend it over, push it into the side so that's not going to rip your fabric, and then get your length. And make it as straight as possible because the wire bends fairly easy even with the headband, and when the headband is made and closed off, it can be hard to unbend the wire. So as you can see what I'm doing down here, so I'm bringing it up to that point because that's how long I want it to be, and down to the other point of the headband. I'll cut this off with my little bit for a hook so it's not sharp. I'll bend that over. I hope my hands aren't too high. I'm actually new to do tutorial, so I'm still trying to get a hang of the hang of my tripod. So back to your gap, the 1 inch gap that you left there, and you just put the wire in now, right down to the point at the end. Then you'll have to bend this one to get it through the other side. That's down at that point as well. So then, as you can see, your wire's in, perfect length, and the final part is just sewing this small part closed. Now, obviously, I'd use red thread normally, but I'm going to use white thread just to show you. So, to go back up to the sewing machine. Now, this is the final part of making a headband, a wire headband. So, back to the gap that we had, we're just going to seal it off. I'm going to use white thread so that you can see the actual stitch. So, turn it around. I sew quite close to the edge so you can't see it. Obviously, you're going to see it with this one, but if you use red thread or the colour of the fabric you're using, or the nearest colour to it, you won't see it. Just look a bit weird if you went in too far with it. Now you can see it there. I'm gonna cut those threads off, and that's the headband done.